My name is John Byrne, and I'm a dance maker. I can make a dance out of anything. My life is choreography and telling stories. My childhood sucked. I was tormented for being different, and after dropping out of 7th grade, I wrote a letter to Oprah, and she invited me to her show. I shared with the world how dance was saving my life. Fortunately, I got a scholarship to the North Carolina School of the Arts, Juilliard, and the School of American Ballet. I left high school early to join the Paul Taylor Dance Company, and I toured around the world performing. 3 years later, I met my boyfriend, photographer David LaChapelle. I quit my job in the dance company and moved to Los Angeles with David. I would go with David to his film sets and studied what everyone did. I became friends with fascinating entertainers like Elton John and Pamela Anderson. One day, I asked David if I could choreograph some dancers who were waiting around on a video shoot for Joss Stone. When David and the crew saw what we came up with, he decided to rework the video's concept into a dance story. A few weeks later, I got a check in the mail, and I was like, wow, I'm gonna make a living as a choreographer. Since then, I have choreographed countless music videos, commercials, and films, and staged photographs at the LaChapelle Studios. So far, I think my biggest accomplishment was choreographing Elton John's Red Piano concert in Vegas. That project put me on the map as a choreographer, and the show was extended 5 years after its original dates. I began to develop my own style and vocabulary. I have always been inspired by the work of Jerome Robbins and Elliot Feld. My ambition is to become a director choreographer like Bob Fosse. My goal is to create incredible dance films like he did, even if I have to do it on my own. The thing that sets me apart from most choreographers is I am completely original. My dances tell stories and they all have a beginning, middle, and end. I never wanted to make dances for pop stars. I want my dances to be the main event. I'm childlike and my nickname is Bambini, but when I'm on set and in the studio, people say I'm like a different person. I'm totally in control. Early on, I made some mistakes in Hollywood. I had to get humble and I went back to New York to study my craft and get inspired. Back in New York, out of curiosity, I decided to see what it was like to be a go-go dancer. In New York, I got my heart broken and had the inspiration I needed to get back on track with my choreography career. Soon after, I had the honor to work with Lady Gaga and choreograph major campaigns including Sony, Pepsi, and NBC's America's Got Talent. I began mentoring with my hero, Richard Simmons, and hosted my own dance DVD. In the UK, I joined a dance reality show on ITV. Since then, I choreograph every day. My philosophy is, if I'm not getting hired to choreograph, I will make my own work. I get my friends involved, like Mama Makeup, Daphne Guinness, Amber Rose, and Pamela Anderson. Pam starred in my adaptation of the Nutcracker Ballet. Recently, after staging Vanity Fair's Young Hollywood cover for Annie Leibovitz, I admitted in an interview that my experience on the shoot was horrible and degrading. But I believe I am a voice to say that people on all levels and sides of the industry should be treated with the same respect. Currently, I am working with Grammy-winning artist NDRE on a new music video that I will choreograph and direct. I'm also working with new Capitol Record artist Loleen in preparation for her debut tour. Last season, I made my rite of passage as a choreographer on So You Think You Can Dance Canada. I hope to soon choreograph on the American version of So You Think You Can Dance or Dancing with the Stars after countless submissions, letters, and proposals. I know I have the talent and drive to create the best work ever on those programs. Life as a dance maker is incredible, but it's a challenging career. I work 24/7, but it's a life of an artist.